to Adept English, Rule 4. You're getting used to the format of our course by now, so every day you receive an email with a video link and an MP3 file and a PDF file. Now, just to recap on the previous rules, Rule 1 says understanding first. Improve your fluency by understanding the language first and foremost. Rule 2 says practice. Practice your understanding by listening to the same piece a number of times. Rule 3 says stick at it. Find yourself a schedule. Find a time when you can do your listening so that you can keep doing it, and use the time when your brain's not entirely occupied. So today we come to Rule 4. Now Rule 4 is be nice to yourself. It means maintain a positive attitude to your learning. Now I'm a psychotherapist by profession, and that means that I work with people who have emotional problems and difficulties. One of the very common problems that people have is that they lack confidence, they don't believe in themselves, and they're very self-critical. They say to themselves things like, oh, I could never do that. I wouldn't be able to. I'm not good enough. I'm too stupid. And in my work, I often call this their internal critic. So it's a very judgmental, quite hard, harsh part of themselves that looks on and says, oh, that's no good. Internal critic isn't necessarily all bad. Sometimes it makes you feel guilty because you've done something wrong, in which case it's doing its job. It may sometimes say things to you like, come on, try harder, just push yourself a bit, you might be able to do it then. Push yourself, you'll do better. So it can be encouraging, but for many people it really isn't, and it can be a problem when you're learning a language. So when you're learning a language, the improvement never goes up. You find sometimes things online which promise that you can become fluent in English in 3 hours. It doesn't work like that. It needs very, very gradual improvement. It's more kind of like this, the improvement in English, or any other language for that matter. You just have to trust in the process. You provide it with the right conditions and your brain will know how to do it, how to go about learning the language. But the problem is with gradual learning. It can be quite, you can feel quite disheartened sometimes. It's not like other types of learning where suddenly you have a breakthrough. It happens bit by bit, not all of a sudden. So it's important when you're learning English to maintain positive thinking. I recommend to you, it's good to be able to understand 70 or 80% of the audio the first few times you hear it. If you keep listening, you'll understand more each time. But don't say to yourself, oh, there's 20% I don't understand, because then you're going to feel discouraged, you're going to feel down about it. It's much better to say to yourself, wow, I understood 80% of that or 70% of that the first time I heard it. If I listen a few more times, I'll understand 95% of it. I'll be so much better than when I started. Now, there's a model of learning which I really like, which I think helps with this. You may have come across it in a different context. It's called, in English, conscious competent model. Now, as I've said before, conscious means what you're aware of, what's happening around you, what's happening in your head, and you know it. And unconscious means it's happening anyway, it's still happening, but you're not really aware of it, you don't know it. Your competence, or if you're competent, it means you're good at something, you've acquired the skill. And if you're incompetent, you've not yet acquired the skill. You're not skilled at it, you're not good at it. Now, in this model, stage one is the first stage of learning, and it's called unconscious incompetence. You're not aware that you're not very good. So you might say, oh, I know what, I'm going to improve my English fluency. How hard can it be? It'll be fine. Pretty soon, you might find yourself moving into stage two, and this stage is conscious incompetence. So you might begin to think, oh, this is really difficult. I can't do it. All sorts of things in English that I don't know. Often people who learn language in school and then try to understand native speakers hit this. Suddenly they realise, oh, I don't understand a normal person speaking English. It can be really difficult to stick at it through this phase, but then you come to stage three, which is unconscious competence. So little by little, out of your awareness, you're getting better and better, but it's very gradual. So you're acquiring competence, but you still feel like you haven't. You're acquiring skill, but you don't yet know it. Stage four in this model is conscious competence. So you know you can do it. You know what you're capable of. It's a really nice place to be, and you can feel competent. It doesn't mean you're speaking English perfectly, but it means that you have confidence. You can hold your own, as we say. You'll be okay. It's really, really hard to stay with language learning through stages two and three, and yet they tend to last a long time. So people can get quite down on themselves and quite down on their ability to learn a language. Remember, every single person who has ever learned English or learned any foreign language will have been at the stage that you are at now. What the difference is between the ones who become fluent and the ones who stay stuck is they keep at it, they stick at it. And they move through these four stages, and gradually their competence, their skill at the language builds up, and gradually they become aware of their skill. They become aware of what they can do this month that last month they wouldn't have understood. Enough for today. I hope you managed to find the time to listen to this piece at least five times. Have a lovely day, and I will see you tomorrow for Rule 5.